Is it visible now? Okay. So yesterday we discussed about what will happen if I have an isolated system, and then we discuss about what are microstates and so on and so forth. So basically we revise some of the concept that we have learned. In today's lecture we are going to discuss about statistical ensemble. So what are the parameters? Yesterday we discussed that the number of accessible state will mainly depend on two parameters only. Which are those two parameters? Energy and number of particle. So if I change energy or number of particle, then my number of accessible states will change. Correct? So based on these two parameters only, I am going to distinguish or I am going to classify the ensembles. Now, if both energy and number of particle, if these both things are constant, what's going to happen? So it's an isolated system. What's going to happen to the accessible states? And accessible states will be same. Or the number will be constant, basically. Correct. Exactly. Okay. And what's going to happen when I have number of accessible states? What's going to happen with the probability of finding the accessible states? Equal means it will be equal to 1 over omega. That's it. So if I'm not going to change, I'm not going to exchange. So if I have a system something like this, and I have another system attached to it, and this system is not exchanging energy or particle with this system. Let's say this is system A and this is system A prime. And if this system A is not exchanging the number of particle or energy with the surrounding system, then such a system which has constant energy and constant number of particle is known as macrocanonical ensemble. Can you thought of any example of this macrocanonical ensemble? Yes, thermas. In thermas, basically for a short time duration, I am not talking about a long time duration, for a short time duration, in thermas case, the energy remain constant. It's not exchanging heat with surrounding. Right? So the energy and the number of particle will remain constant. So thermas is one of the example of such a system. Right? Now what I can do, I can say that, okay, these are the two systems, system A and system A prime. This can be surrounding. It doesn't matter. And this system can exchange energy. I am allowing the exchange of energy. Energy can be exchanged. Now, what's going to happen? Energy will change. Okay, so what can happen? This system A, the particle of system A can exchange heat or energy with A prime, and their total energy will change. And what's going to happen when the energy is changed for this particular system A prime? A. What will going to happen to the omega E? Omega. Will it remain constant? No, it is going to change. It will going to change. So if I allow the exchange of energy, what's going to happen? Omega will change. And what's going to happen to the probability of finding the system in energy state E if omega is going to change? This will not be constant. It is not constant. This will change with time. Okay. In canonical, microcanonical ensemble, probability of finding a system in one particular energy state is constant forever. Right? And over here in canonical, so when I allow the exchange of energy, so such an ensemble is known as canonical ensemble. So I am going to allow energy to exchange, but I am fixing the number of particle to be constant. Such a system is known as canonical ensemble, and in this particular case the accessible states will change. And hence, P of E will not be constant. Correct? So instead of P of E, let me call it as P of microstate. Probability of finding a system in a particular microstate will change continuously. So that is your canonical ensemble. Now what will happen in grand canonical ensemble? Both will change. I can change both. I can exchange both energy and I can exchange number of particles. This is the total energy. This is the total number of particles of a system. So again, if I am going to change energy and number of particle, what will going to happen to the accessible states? Accessible state will remain same. No. It will change. It's a function of energy and number of particle. If I change the energy or change the number of particle, the number of accessible state will change. And hence again over here, the probability of finding a system in any particular microstate will not be constant. So when I fix the energy and fix the number of particles, such a system is known as microcanonical ensemble. If I allow the energy to be exchanged, then it is called as canonical ensemble. And if I allow energy as well as number of particles to be exchanged, it is known as grand canonical ensemble. Easier? Yes. Now let's discuss a little bit about this. Now if the energy is not energy is exchanging and the number of particle is becoming constant, what else will be constant for such a system? So let me put it in another word. So you said that the example for microcanonical ensemble is thermos, right? Can you think of an example of canonical ensemble? Where energy can be exchanged but number of particle cannot be exchanged. So you said that this example is thermos. And you are talking about very short period. When you are considering thermos, you are talking about very short period. Let's say 10-20 minutes. क्योंकि उसके बाद फिर से वो एनर्जी एक्सचेंज करने लगेगा. What will be the example over here for canonical ensemble? Melting of ice. Yes. और दूसरा, you think of any process, physical process, it will be most probably a canonical ensemble. For example, let's say मैंने फ्रिज से एक बॉटल निकाली एंड आई पुट दैट ऑन माई काउंटर. ओके, सो कोल्ड बॉटल एट रूम टेम्परेचर, दिस विल बी अ कैनोनिकल एनसेम्बल. इट इज ओनली एक्सचेंजिंग एनर्जी, इट इज नॉट एक्सचेंजिंग पार्टिकल्स, राइट? ओके, नाउ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम्पल, the number of particles are remaining constant. At equilibrium, when the equilibrium situation is achieved, at equilibrium what will be constant? In dono cases mein kya constant hone wala hai? Melting of ice matlab aapne let's say cold bottle at room temperature. Maine bottle room mein se nikali, fridge mein se nikali aur मेरे काउंटर पे रख दी, उसके बाद में क्या होगा? सो इट विल एक्सचेंज एनर्जी विथ सराउंडिंग, राइट? एनर्जी मतलब क्या एग्जैक्टली? क्या एक्सचेंज करेगा? इट विल एक्सचेंज हीट विथ द सराउंडिंग। वो तो इनिशियली मेरे बॉटल का टेम्परेचर कुछ लेट्स से 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस था, सराउंडिंग का टेम्परेचर 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस था, दे स्टार्टेड एक्सचेंजिंग हीट। सो मेरे बॉटल ने सराउंडिंग में से हीट एब्जॉर्ब करना शुरू कर दिया। वट विल हैपन आफ्टर सम टाइम? कुठल्या स्टेजला? एक्झॅक्टली, वेन इक्विलिब्रियम इज अचीव्ड द टेम्परेचर विल रिमेन कॉन्स्टंट। सो फॉर कॅनॉनिकल एन्सेम्बल्स इक्विलिब्रियम इज अचीव्ड वेन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सिस्टीम ऑफ द बोथ सिस्टीम विल बी सेम। सो सपोज इफ दिस इज द केस, आय हॅव अ सिस्टीम ए over here and A prime in contact with that particular system, then they will start exchanging the energy, and the exchange of energy will stop when the temperature of A, TA, and temperature of A prime, so when TA is equal to TA prime, this is achieved, and that time you say that you have achieved a equilibrium. Iska matlab aisa hai kya ki wo energy exchange nahi karenge ek dusre ke sath? They will stop exchanging energy? No, they can. They can exchange energy. Basically, what I am trying to say that they will start exchanging. They will continue exchanging energy, but their temperature will remain constant and the equilibrium is achieved because the energy of this complete system will be constant. So, not only. You cannot say that A is at in equilibrium. You have to say that A is in equilibrium with A prime. Okay. And the constant, this energy, total energy of the system will be constant. Please remember, temperature is not an absolute quantity. It's an average quantity. So they will continue exchanging energy with each other. So, शायद ऐसा हो सकता है कि इसने यहाँ से एक particle ने one unit of energy exchange किया, तो यहाँ से दूसरा particle one unit of energy back exchange karega. You are getting my point? So that the total energy will remain constant. So this is about your canonical ensemble. So in a canonical ensemble, your temperature will remain constant. What, can you give me the example of grand canonical ensemble? Any examples? Jaha pe matter as well as energy exchange ho rahi hai? Boiling of water. Yes, boiling of water. Again, any chemical process. So, yaha pe both energy as well as number of particles is getting exchanged. So, when such thing is happening, you say that in such a system, jaise ki yaha pe canonical ensemble mein, टेम्परेचर मेरा कॉन्स्टेंट हो रहा था एट इक्विलिब्रियम, यहां पे आप बोलते हो एट इक्विलिब्रियम टेम्परेचर कॉन्स्टेंट बोलने की जगह मैं बोल रहा हूं कि टेम्परेचर ऑफ सिस्टम ए विल बी इक्वल टू टेम्परेचर ऑफ सिस्टम ए प्राइम। सिमिलरली यहां पे देर विल बी समथिंग नोन एज केमिकल पोटेंशियल विच विल रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट। So chemical potential of system A will be equal to chemical potential of system A prime. So what is this chemical potential? We are going to discuss that while we discuss grand canonical ensemble. So for the time being, it is some quantity similar to temperature, but it involves particle. So for grand canonical ensemble, this chemical potential will remain constant. For canonical ensemble, the temperature will be constant. And for microcanonical ensemble, obviously there will be no exchange of energy. So, temperature, energy, number of particle, all will be constant. Now, this microcanonical ensemble is very rare. You will not encounter microcanonical ensemble a lot. However, the occurrence of canonical and grand canonical ensembles are very often any physical system you see, it will most probably be a canonical ensemble. Any chemical system you see, it most probably will be a grand canonical ensemble. So these two ensembles are very, very important. And in both the cases, the probability of finding the system in any particular microstate is going to change. However, for microcanonical ensemble, the probability of finding the system in any microstate is constant forever. So let's talk about this. So we discuss about canonical ensemble. So what's going to happen in canonical ensemble? The probability of finding the particle will be 1 over omega, and that will be equal to constant. So now what we are going to do, we are going to find out this probability for canonical and grand canonical ensemble. So these are the ensemble where there is a interaction between two systems. So let me call it as, let's say I have a system A, so I'm talking about canonical ensemble. So let's see what's going to happen when two systems interact with each other. So suppose this is system A, and this system is in thermal contact with another system A prime. So when I say thermal contact with the another system, it means that it can exchange heat energy with another system. And the number of particle, the walls of this system is such that it can allow the exchange of energy, but it will not allow the exchange of particles. Now this A prime can be another system, or it can be a thermal reservoir. What is thermal reservoir, by the way? Yes, correct, correct. Both of you are correct. So thermal reservoir is a system which has large heat capacity. What will happen if a system has a large heat capacity? It can absorb large amount of heat, but the temperature will remain constant. So heat reservoir is a system which can absorb a large amount of heat energy, but its temperature will not change. So this another system can be A prime can be another system or thermal reservoir, right? And here the energy is E. The energy of system A is E. Energy of system A prime is E prime. The number of particle of system A is n. The number of particle in system A prime is n prime. So what we are going to consider? We are going to consider that only energy is exchanged. So energy of A is equal to E. Energy of A prime is equal to E prime. What will be the energy of total system? क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स पढ़ा है ना आपने, कैसे फाइंड आउट करते हैं सिस्टम का एनर्जी, इंटरैक्टिंग सिस्टम का एनर्जी. फॉर दैट यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज टोटल हैमिल्टोनियन ऑफ अ सिस्टम. एंड टोटल हैमिल्टोनियन ऑफ टू इंटरैक्टिंग सिस्टम इज गिवन बाय हैमिल्टोनियन ऑफ ए प्लस हैमिल्टोनियन ऑफ ए प्राइम प्लस एच इंटरैक्शन. सो दिस विल गिव मी इंटरैक्शन. बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरैक्शन what is going to happen to the energy. So basically this is the exchange energy, right? And if the interactions is weak, then H interaction will be much, much smaller than HA or H prime, HA prime. So what we are going to consider here is weak interactions. So if interaction is very, very weak, then the total Hamiltonian will be equal to Hamiltonian of A plus Hamiltonian of A prime. So what will be the energy? Total energy E plus E dash. So let me call this total energy, instead of ET, I'm going to call it as E0. So what I have is total energy of a system, combined system, is equal to E plus E prime. And please note that this is because there is a weak interaction between the system. If the interaction is strong, then there will be an additional term over here. Okay, so let's talk about this weak interaction, because in statistical mechanics we are not going to look at strong interactions explicitly, we'll be looking at weak interactions only. So this is the total energy of a system. And what is the total system? Total system is A plus A prime. So this is the total system. What we are interested in? We are interested in finding out the probability of finding the system in one particular microstates. So we are interested in probability. To find a probability, what we require? Number of accessible state. So we will be calculating what are the number of accessible states. I am going to say that P of E is probability that the system A has energy E when total energy of a system is E0. P of E is the probability that the system A has an energy E when the total energy of a system, combined system. Let me write that explicitly over here. Combined system is E0. So basically P of E is the probability such that A has an energy E, A prime has an energy E prime, and hence E0 is equal to E plus E prime. Correct? Ye wala. So what that will be equal to? Kya hota hai probability? Mere paas 10 balls hai. Usme se 5 ball green hai, 5 ball red hai. What is the probability that I will get a green ball? 5 by 10 kaise calculate kiya aapne? Wo kitne unka number kitna hai divided by total number. Right? So yahan pe mujhe kya chahiye? Yahan pe. System A has a energy E. तो यहाँ पे क्या लिखूंगा मैं? वो नंबर कैसे मिलेगा मुझे? Accessible state, number of accessible state. So यहाँ पे मैं लिखूंगा number of accessible states when A has energy E and total energy is E0 divided by what? Total number of accessible states. Total number of accessible state when total energy is E0. Now, kiske accessible states you are talking about? Are you talking about accessible state of system A? You are talking about accessible states of system A prime? Or you are talking about the total system? Look over here. What you are saying? E, energy E hai and total energy E0 hai, complete system. So, you are talking about these are the number of accessible states of combined system. So, these accessible states are of combined system. Why I am considering total system? Why I am not considering only system A? My question is, why we are going to consider the combined system? Why not only A? And the answer is really very simple. We are considering the interactions. And since interaction is happening, this energy E is not constant anymore. It is continuously changing. And so is E prime. It is constantly changing. And if it is constantly changing, will the number of accessible state remain constant? No. So it will continuously change. How am I going to count them? No. It is impossible because it is continuously changing. So that's why I am considering the combined system. Because for combined system, E0 is constant. Agar E badhega to E prime kam hona chahiye utne amount se. That's what this equation says. This equation says that the energy of the combined system is constant. E and E prime are changing. So E agar 10 se bada to E prime 10 se kam honga. E agar 100 se bada to E prime 100 se kam honga. And so on and so forth. That's the reason I need to consider the combined system. So now our job is to reduce to find out the accessible states of combined system. Konse accessible state? Aise accessible state when the A has energy E and total number of accessible states. So let me write that over here. Omega 0, E 0. This is number of accessible states of combined system when the total energy is E0. Omega 0 E is number of accessible state when system A has energy E, and obviously total energy of combined system is E0. And let me write over here, omega 0 E prime is number of accessible states when system A prime has energy E and total number of combined system, E prime and total number of combined system is E0. Again, I am going to say omega E. It's not omega 0 E. It's omega E is number of accessible states of system A when A has energy E, and omega 0 E prime is number of accessible states of system A prime when A prime has energy E prime. So what is the difference between this and this? ओमेगा जीरो जो लिखा है वहां पे हम कंबाइंड सिस्टम के एक्सेसिबल स्टेट देख रहे हैं, और जहां पे सिर्फ ओमेगा लिखा है वहां पे उस सिस्टम के पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम के स्टेट देख रहे हैं. विल दे बी डिफरेंट? डिफरेंट रहेंगे कैसे क्या? लेट मी टेक एन एग्जांपल क्विकली सो दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस कि दीज आर डिफरेंट थिंग. सपोज आई हैव अ सिस्टम वेयर आई हैव टू पार्टिकल्स एंड द टोटल एनर्जी इज 2e ओनली. ओके, so this is my system A. So 0, 1E, 2E. What are the different accessible states? So I could have one particle over here and one particle over here. So the number of different accessible states will be 2. What is the another combination? I could have both the particles in energy and the number of accessible states is 1. So what is the total number of accessible state for a system A with energy 2e and number of particle 2? Number of accessible states 2 plus 1, 3, right? And I have another system is something like this. Yahan pe mere sirf ek particle hai. One particle and total energy is 2e. Nahi, yahan pe two particle. One particle agar lunga to same hi rahega. Two particle and total energy is let's say 1e. 0, 1e, 2e. What are the different number of accessible state that is possible? This is the only configuration that is possible, correct? One particle in energy 1e and another particle in 0, correct? So what are the total number of accessible state over here? 2. And again I have another system with total number of particle 2 and total energy is 2e. So what are the possible states of this system? These are the possible states, correct? So the number of accessible state is 2 over here is 1. Aur koi possibility hai kya is system ke liye? Now what is the probability that the system will have omega 2e? मतलब सिस्टम ए का एनर्जी 2e होगा, ऐसे नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स कितने हैं? इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? ओमेगा 2e का मतलब किसका? सिस्टम ए के नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स ओनली. सो दैट वुड बी कितने हैं? 2 प्लस 1, 3, राइट? मगर अगर मैं इस सिस्टम बी को कंसीडर कर रहा हूं, सो ए प्लस बी मेरी कंबाइंड सिस्टम है. टोटल एनर्जी ई जीरो कितना हो गया मेरा? 3e. नाउ व्हाट विल बी माय ओमेगा 0 2e? ओमेगा 0 2e का मतलब क्या है? करेक्ट. सो दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ अ कंबाइंड सिस्टम व्हेन ए हैज एनर्जी 2e एंड टोटल एनर्जी इज 3e. how many accessible states will be there. The first combination can be something like this. System, this is system A, this is system B. System A can have something like this. 0, 1E, 2E. One particle over here and second particle over here. And B will have one particle over here, two particle over here. Barabar? Another combination could be something like this. System A ka one number particle over here honga, two number ka particle here aapke honga. Magar iska, correct? Another combination kya ho sakta hai? Another combination will be two over here, one over here. और इसका वन टू, अनदर कॉम्बिनेशन टू ओवर हियर वन ओवर हियर, इसका करेक्ट बराबर है क्या? कुछ रिपीट नहीं हो रहा है उसमें? अभी मैं नेक्स्ट स्टेट पे जाऊंगा. नेक्स्ट स्टेट इज दिस. So what I'm going to have is I could have for system A, I could have 1 and 2, but for system B I can have only, oh sorry, yahan pe ha ye a 2 energy bhi nahi rahenge, 1 energy rahega iska, sorry, 1 2, and I could have, when the this is the case, I could have 1 and 2, barabar. And the last situation will be something like this. Both particles are over here and these are 2, 3. Kitne accessible states ho gaye, count karo. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Kuch to maine repeat count kiya hoga kahi pe to. Anyway, so my point is this omega E and this will be different, right? So these are different, these will not be same. That's my point. So this omega 0 and omega E, they will be different, they will not be same. Yahan pe dekho, jab main sirf single system ko consider kar raha hu, that time I am going to get 3 accessible states. And but when I am going to consider a combined system A and B, I am going to get 9 accessible states. So this omega and omega 0, these are different things. So yahan pe aapki kya kiya hai, not only omega, ek agar mera iska accessible states hai, system A ka accessible states hai, to usko maine iske har ek accessible state ke sath combine kiya hai. Yahan pe dekho, 1, 2 को मैंने किसके साथ कंबाइन किया है, इसके हर एक पॉसिबल एक्सेसिबल स्टेट 1, 2, 2, 1. सिमिलरली ए जो मेरा एक्सेसिबल स्टेट था, उसको फिर से मैंने इसके अलग अलग एक्सेसिबल स्टेट के साथ मैच किया हुआ है, राइट? सो बेसिकली बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ कंप्लीट सिस्टम एंड द सिंगल सिस्टम विल बी डिफरेंट. Even though we are talking about the system A having energy, same energy. Understood? Now what will be this probability E in terms of these symbols? How can I write P of E in terms of these symbols, omegas? That will be omega 0 E 0 correct? So what is this probability of finding the energy proportional to? This will be the total number of state, and since the total energy is constant, this will be constant. Agar total energy mera constant hai, energy agar constant hai, the number of accessible state will be constant. right? So this omega total will be constant, right? So P of E will be only proportional to omega 0 of E. And what is omega 0 of E? So it is the accessible states of combined system. And now our job is to calculate this omega 0 E 0. So this omega 0, E is equal to how much that we need to calculate. Now, how you have calculated this omega 0 E in this particular example? Yahan pe? You have taken what are the accessible states of system A and you combine them with each state with all the states of system B. Whatever. So basically what you have done, you have taken omega E for system A and you have multiplied it by omega B of another system. Waisa hi honga na? Multiplication hi honga ho? Right? Now, abhi yaha pe mere paas kya hai? System A hai and I have system A prime. The energy of system A is E, the energy of system A is A prime is E prime. And the number of accessible states of system A is E, the number of accessible state of system A is E prime, right? And I have E0, total energy is equal to E plus E prime. And since this is constant, E0 is constant, I can write E prime is equal to E0 minus E. So, what does that mean? Iska matlab kya hua? E prime depends on what is E. So, instead of writing this something like this, I can write it something like this. Because E prime itself depend on E. Samajh mein aa raha hai ki main kya keh raha hu? E prime independent hai kya? Wo independent kuch value le sakta hai kya? It depends on E. That's why it is a function of E. So omega prime is the energy accessible states of system A prime when it has energy E prime. But it depends on E. So I can write instead of omega prime E prime, I can write omega prime E. Because it depends on E. So instead of using two variables, E and E prime, I can use only one variable. It is for mathematical simplicity. So I can write omega 0 E is equal to omega E into omega prime E. And the probability of finding a system such that system A has energy E is equal to or proportional to omega E into omega prime. What is omega E? Main pooch raha hu, kiske states hai wo? Omega E. Omega is the accessible states of system A only. Omega prime E, accessible states of system A prime. Right? So this is the probability. Now what's going to happen when energy is changed? What will going to happen to P of E? It will also change. And end energy changing over here. It is exchanging energy with this. So A energy change ho rahi hai nahi ho rahi hai? So that's the point. So this omega E will be changing continuously. P of E will be changing continuously. So this is what happens when you have a combined system. when you have a combined system, the probability depends on what is your energy. So, क्या फिर ये एक्सचेंज होते ही रहेंगे क्या? कुछ होगा ही नहीं क्या इसके बारे में? इक्विलिब्रियम सिचुएशन आने के बाद क्या होगा? सो दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट कैनोनिकल सिस्टम इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. फॉर यू हियर इज अ प्रॉब्लम, यू नीड टू सॉल्व द नंबर ऑफ एसिजिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ कंबाइंड सिस्टम. सो बेसिकली यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट वट विल बी omega 2e and omega 0 2e when this system A and there is system C. I have only two particles with energy 2e. This is system A and system C is two particle and energy 2e. आपको find out करना है what are the accessible states of system A when it has energy 2e, and need to find out what is the number of accessible states of combined system when the system A has energy 2e. So you need to find out what is omega 2e and omega 0 2e when you are going to consider system A and system C, and you need to verify this. So you also need to calculate omega prime e. Tomorrow you are going to share that with me. Thank you for your time. We'll discuss in the next lecture, remaining part. Thank you.